I'm Dr. Paul Chedilin. I'm from Department of Radiology, Government Medical College, Kozhikode. The co-author is Dr. Joanna P. My topic is prenatal diagnosis of a case of DiGeorge syndrome. Abstract. 22q deletion syndrome or DiGeorge syndrome is often diagnosed prenatally with cardiac and extracardiac anomalies. A diagnosis should be considered in all cases of prenatally diagnosed congenital heart disease, particularly when it is associated with thymic hyperplasia. Fluorescence in situ hybridization or microarray is warranted in all cases of structural abnormalities which are diagnosed prenatally. The prenatal diagnosis and counseling is mandatory in expectant parents regarding pregnancy outcome and neonatal management. I am reporting a case of DiGeorge syndrome in a fetus and discussing the imaging features with genotypic correlation and postmortem phenotypic follow-up. Introduction. DiGeorge or 22q11 deletion syndrome is the most common human chromosomal microdeletion syndrome. It is caused by a developmental defect of the third and the fourth pharyngeal pouches and the fourth aortic arch. Craniofacial anomalies such as cleft palate, micrognathia, eye anomalies, etc. are seen. Congenital heart disease, mainly conotruncal anomalies, are noted. An absent or a small thymus or an absent parathyroid gland causing hypocalcemia and immunodeficiency are found. Rarely, musculoskeletal anomalies are also seen. Case report. A 28-year-old primary gravida, non-consanguineous marriage on a routine anomaly scan revealed a fetus of 20 weeks, 3 days gestation with normal interval growth and biometry. In the three-vessel trachea view, the aortic arch was seen to the right of the trachea with left-sided ductus, confirming a right-sided aortic arch. An aberrant vessel with arterial flow was found, coursing behind the esophagus towards the left arm and was diagnosed to be an aberrant left subclavian artery. The three-vessel view showed absence of thymus and anterior displacement of the great vessels. The thymic thoracic ratio was 0.14. Normally, it is 0.44. A bifiduvula was visualized at the level of the oropharynx. This is a grayscale image showing pulmonary artery, trachea, and aorta. Normally, pulmonary artery and aorta is seen towards the left of the trachea, but here, aortic arch is seen towards the right of the trachea, confirming it to be a right-sided aortic arch. This is a corresponding colored upper image showing pulmonary artery, ductus arteriosus, aorta and aortic arch joining together to form the classical U sign, which is seen just posterior to the trachea. This is a grayscale image showing a left-sided ductus arteriosus, which is seen to the left of the trachea, confirming it to be a left ductus arteriosus. This is another grayscale image at the level of the clavicle showing a left aberrant subclavian artery, which is coursing towards the left arm of the fetus. The normal right subclavian artery and aorta is seen. This is an image showing the thymic thoracic ratio. This measurement is the AP diameter of the thymus, which is very small. The distance from the posterior aspect of the sternum to the anterior aspect of the aortic arch is measured. And another measure from the posterior aspect of the sternum to the anterior aspect of the vertebral body is taken. And these two measurements are divided to get the thymic thoracic ratio. It was found to be 0.14, which is way less than the normal measurement 0.44. Again, at the level of the oropharynx, you can see the alveolar ridge, the base of the tongue, and in a normal fetus, the classic equal to sign is noted, confirming the presence of a normal uvula. But in our case, there was a double equal to sign confirming a bifiduvula at the level of the oropharynx. An amniocentesis with cytogenomic microarray analysis showed a loss involving chromosome 22 at cytoregion Q11.21, confirming it to be DiGeorge syndrome. This is an image showing deletion at the 22nd chromosome in a chromosomal microarray study. Fetal echo on the 23rd week of gestation confirmed the findings of right-sided aortic arch, aberrant left subclavian artery, and absent thymus. The pregnancy was terminated before 24 weeks and postmortem examination of the abortus showed bifiduvula and absent thymus. Now these are the images showing a bifiduvula of the abortus and a grayscale image showing an absent or a reduced thymus and a reduced thymic thoracic ratio in the abortus. Discussion. Cardiovascular anomalies remains the most striking sonographic feature, suggests an underlying prenatal diagnosis of 22q11 syndrome. Most cases that are diagnosed prenatally have an abnormal fetal cardiac structure and typically constitutes conotruncal malformations such as interrupted aortic arch type B, right-sided aortic arch, tetralogy of Fallot, truncus arteriosus, and pulmonary atresia with BST. On detecting these cardiac defects prenatally, 22q11 must be considered as a differential diagnosis and should be included in parental counseling. Absent or hypoplastic thymus is best diagnosed using the three-vessel view. The fetal thymus is well developed by this gestation age and can be identified on ultrasound by looking at a cross-sectional plane of the chest between the fetal lungs and the great vessels, where the thigh box is situated. Fluorescence in situ hybridization, multiplex ligation-dependent probe amplification, and chromosomal microarray analysis can confirm the most common 1.5 to 3 MB deletions in fetuses with features of 22q11 through amniocentesis or chorionic villus sampling. Recently, non-invasive prenatal screening for microdeletion syndromes from cell-free fetal DNA in maternal plasma is advised. Conclusion. While the majority of the congenital heart diseases are initially detected on routine mid-trimester anomaly scan, follow-up with fetal echocardiogram in consultation with a maternal fetal medicine specialist or a pediatric cardiologist remains critical, best classifying, diagnosing, and creating a postnatal treatment plan to maximize the outcome. These are my references. Thank you.